I'm the Monday morning racer, Lee Kraft. zMAX Dragway there behind me, and the event has just wrapped up here on a Monday, it being postponed due to rain from Sunday. And I hung out Friday, Sunday, and Monday with the Paul Richards Racing Nitro Funny Car team for another undercover film looking into the world of Nitro. That's next on Monday Morning Racer.
Where everything happens. Clutch department, all our spares, clutch, distance, floaters, keep everything down here, spare flywheel, hat, cabinets, books with notes, specialty tools, running through, nuts, bolts, extra hardware, the works, everything we need to service and put together the clutch stays in the back cabinets back here. See, we got a couple packs ready to go in. Here and here. Let's move on. Cylinder heads, spare heads up top. Have to have several sets to go on the road. Moving down. Miscellaneous pulleys, hardware, blower parts. Here's the pistons and rods department. We're a little low right now. Sleeves. Got three more racks ready to go in. Down here, move on. Any kind of tool you could possibly want or need is in these drawers, or up and above in these cabinets. Here's our ignition section. It's all our electrical parts, computer hardware, in and out. MSD, wires, boxes, coils, spare mags, wires. Kevin, so we just throw stuff in. Spark plugs, extra valves. And now, and this is the motor department. We're keep the spare short box. Spare starter. Those are both ready to go. Superchargers. Can't apologize for the mess, we've been rooting through here. Injector, everything ready to go, and all the other necessary parts needed to make those work. So, and radios and headsets and masks for warm the car. And last but not least, crew uniforms. Oh no, that's the nickel tour right there.
If you want to later, But the thing would be happy with it. This fucking thing will work inside.
Yeah.
But this thing would be.
Where's the watch that was on here?
The one with that?
That's
one right there.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. Cool.
Well,
your side short, yeah.
Tighten down and short.
Yeah, doing this a couple of times will help our nuts and shit. Everything gets diving in.
Yeah.
Down in front, push my boat. Gotta get even with you, man.
He gotta get his kickstands in, Mike.
Yeah, that was coming now. You have three of yours?
Yeah, I have three.
Yeah, middle, go ahead and go middle first.
Alright.
Are you snug?
Yep.
Bring it down.
Alright.
Tight?
Back. Yep.
Okay, down to the rear. Let's see what you got. Yep, come on. Cool. Now the front?
Yep.
Ready, go.
Yep.
Okay, back to the middle when you're ready.
Yep.
All right, check them all. Be done with it.
They are jacked.
This thing's pretty bulletproof.
Yeah.
It kind of lays right, you know?
Yeah. There's other, remember those big nuts they have?
Yeah.
With the washer on the bottom or whatever?
Yeah.
Yeah, you tighten those too much, you pop them right out like,
oh. Oh yeah.
What do you do with the bottom strap?
I don't remember. I think we tied it to the frame, but I'm not sure what we did. Even when this car sits in the lab.
Yeah.
That later, mess with that. Stevie, I remember what we did. Pretty good about that. He's young.
Thank you. Yeah. set.
Silver bullet.
Thank you.
fast track. Just pass that track. I told him not to start!
I had to put the car back, it wouldn't move. I put the car back.
Don't do that!
No?
Let me get my side in. Hold on.
Spread it for me. Spread it.
I didn't spread it.
Oh yeah.
Huh?
They did this before. Mine did it and you did it.
Mike, coming at you.
Come on. Beat him, swing at three.
Alright. Rolling.
Which one's which?
That one's two.
How do I get all these bearings in my hand?
You need to keep bearing. Do not mix the bearings. We don't know what's what here. It fell out.
That's a bottom. That's a bottom. Shutdown area. Hot. Clutch pedal stuck inside the car.
Paper seven. Why don't you take it? Clutch pedal off.
It is off.
There's the bearing for 7-8 coming out. There's the bearing for 8. Turn it.
Okay.
8. Right here.
Hey, you
got a turn?
No.
Take your time, don't get excited. Cap number seven,
let's follow this one on. Yeah, hook up over here.
Second way.
Ain't that bad.
It would have ran good if that didn't have that hole out.
Happen, happen.
Is the saw bearing in the way?
That one was dead to the freight. Alright, pedal. Look at that.
You can take the top off the car and then it'll just run.
Come on, I just see it slide back. Hey, we're sliding back. I'm going to get you. What's it do? Get you out of here.
Hey. Are you raising my gas?
take a photo of it.
Huh? Nice cold. Cold time, dude's coming on. Right here.
Can you get it up there? You download that?
Hey, download the warm up.
There you go. I want to keep those in line there.
All right. You got it. You on six.
All right, come in.
You can't take them down till it cools off next time. Okay. So you go and put the head on. I need one.
Where's the sleeve, Doctor? Here.
Side of the rings.
You need me to turn it around?
Good. Let's go. Turn it.
Bring it down.
Turn it. There you go.
A lot of load.
Come on. Turn it. Turn it. Turn it. Let's go. Turn it. Turn it. Come on. Turn it. Turn it. Turn it. Turn it. Come on. Come on. Come on out. Come on out. Come on out. Come on. Nice and easy. Come on out. Turn it. 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 Watch your open.
I
morning racer caught up with Dave Richards after a good first Q1 run. Look, Dave, give us the rundown because there was some crashing going on in the pits. Got everything worked out. Go up to the line and make a pretty good run. So give me from your perspective.
Over here. It was a good run. We definitely had a lot of pressure coming into this whole weekend. And then right before we were about to run, we had some issues with the cannon. Thought we had some air. We were able to resolve the problem. And going up there just hoping that everything was going to work properly. And obviously it did. The car ran really well. And everyone's been working really hard. And starting the weekend off, that run is the way you always want to start a weekend off. You're not constantly behind the eight ball chasing your tail, second guessing yourself. So it's a good starting point, and I'm looking forward to the next run tonight. Weather's getting a little cooler, so we're going to try and run a little faster, and we're going to see what happens.
Definitely, I was going to ask, are y'all going to try to step it up, get a little bit more out of it? So good to hear that. Look, anyone right now that you want to give a shout out to that's helping you being out here driving this Nitro Funny Car?
Yeah, we definitely have a lot of help this weekend with Prestige Siteworks, the Mahoney family. Strutmasters has come on board for this race. And as always, we still have Farm Boy and Uppercut Turf Management. They've all been helping us through the years. They've kept us out here in order for us to keep racing. And we're just having a lot of fun, and that's what it's all about for us, just having a good time.
All right, Dave, thank you. We'll catch up with you later.
Okay.
Thank you.
6:58 to 6:56. Derek Kramer's car, living under power.
We knew Jake just laid down a really nice run. He said if you stay shallow, hit your ship points, we're going right back to the top. So to hear that confidence in the premiership, it does a lot for me. And it reminds me of 2015. So we're just having fun. But for Gallagher, for transportation.
Monday morning racer caught up with Dave again. He's the driver of the Nitro Funny Car of the Paul Richards Racing Team. Got Strutmasters on board this weekend. Dave, look, wasn't here Saturday. Y'all obviously were. You're in the show. Give me a rundown of what Saturday was like for y'all.
Saturday we finished off pretty strong with the fourth qualifying session. That we tried a few things with the clutch and we really picked up all the early incrementals. So I was really excited about the way the car was going to run today. Based on what we learned yesterday. So that's really what I'm looking forward to is a good race day tomorrow.
Definitely, and tomorrow is Monday.
Monday.
It's not Sunday.
Right.
We've been rained out, postponed. Right. It has played peekaboo with us all day. Rain, slack off, rain, slack off. So for you as a driver, how challenging is that?
It's just frustrating because we've been here since 6:30 this morning. You just wait, see some blue skies, and then you get ready to go. I was actually getting my fire suit on when it started raining again, so it's just frustrating to sit around and wait all the anticipation and hype of trying to make a good run. And you know, unfortunately, it's raining and drag racing really sucks. So it's just frustrating. That's all it is.
Yes, sir. Well, look, there's tomorrow. Y'all are in the show. We hope you run well.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
This is terrible. Not at all. going to be our final pair. And we've got pro stop at the ready line.
Thank you.
Sunday morning racer. We're here in the pits at the Carolina Nationals zMAX Dragway. Caught up with Dave Richards once again. Dave, you've had a good weekend for your team. Talk to me about Friday, Saturday, up to round one.
Yeah, the weekend definitely turned out okay. Always qualifying to race on race day is always a good thing. But to start out the way we did on Friday with that 407 run, really set the pace for the weekend. It takes a lot of pressure off when you run good right out of the box. And, you know, we hadn't raced in 5 months. And, you know, having new sponsors on board like Strutmasters and having our other sponsors, you know, Prestige and Uppercut and Turf, you know, there's always a little more pressure to do good for your sponsors. And I think we did good. We definitely learned a lot. And I think based on what we came up here to do is more or less just test and try some new things, and they really did work. So I feel good about the future. I think we're going to do some more racing next year, more than we did this year. So I'm looking forward to that, and I think we're on the right page.
Awesome. So got a bright future ahead of you. Let's talk just a little bit in the past, though. Round one. Now, you got in the show on a 407. You were 14th on the board. Went up against Matt Hagen. As I said earlier to you, you got the pool man versus the farmer. And it didn't go so well for you. Even broke a wheelie bar on the funny car. Talk to me about the run.
Yeah, the run definitely didn't go like we planned. We were hoping to, you know, make a full pass and let them beat themselves. You know, we were hoping to run good. Somehow the wheelie bar broke, and I don't know if that maybe affected something on the run. There's a good chance it did. So, you know, you always want more. You're always a little disappointed. You know, you want to win. But, you know, things happen, and fortunately, you know, that wheelie bar broke. It could have been way worse. So we came here, we're, you know, with a race car and the same motor, and we're leaving here with a race car and the same motor that's in the car. So that's always a positive for a team like ours. So, you know, all in all, we got to race on Sunday and get to race against the best of the best here at the NHRA, so we're lucky. And I'm just glad to be doing this, and I go home tomorrow and I got to clean some swimming pools.
Right, yeah, tell me about that. You, on the 9-to-5, though I'm sure it's not a 9-to-5 job, you are in the pool industry. Tell me what you do.
Yeah, I own my own swimming pool company. We do maintenance repair. So that's what pays the bills, and then we get to go racing and have fun. So that's kind of like my stress relief, even though I probably have more stress about the race car than I do the business. You know, all in all, life's good, and I'm glad that I'm able to come out and play and race at Nitro Funny Car.
Awesome. For a little bit of fun, man, so folks get to know you a little bit better, if you hit shuffle on your playlist, whether it's Spotify or Apple iTunes, what songs are you hoping you hear?
I like everything, really. I mean, I like country music, I like rock and roll, even some rap I like, you know. I like it all. I don't really even listen to the lyrics, so people say, well, what song is this or what song is that? I just like what sounds good, so, you know, I'm kind of easy going. I just like whatever, really. I'm not, you know, picky about it.
Awesome. Well, folks, that's been Dave, the pool man, Richards, on the Monday Morning Racer camera.
All right, thank you.
Caught up with Paul Richards. He's the owner of Paul Richards Racing, which Dave Richards, that we already talked to, drives and pilots down the quarter mile, the 1,000 feet. So, Paul, look, this year y'all made several events here in the Southeast. This is your last event for this year. What has this year meant for this team and growing and building and making shows and performing?
Well, it's good that, you know, we went to 4 races, qualified at all 4. We're hurting a little bit of parts here and there, but we've gotten better and better each race we've gone to. And particularly this weekend, it seemed like we learned a good deal that's going to propel us into next season. Go a little quicker, better on parts, and, you know, overall better deal for us and the sponsors.
Yeah, I know. Talking to you off camera, you mentioned you hope to at least get to about a 10-race schedule through the season. What is it going to take from the business side of things to be able to do that? What does a Nitro Funny Car team need to do 10 races?
A lot. you just need a multitude of parts. The shop has to be full. You got to start with, you know, 8 racks of pistons and rods. You got to have, you know, hundreds of clutch discs, 4 good motors. For us, we're going to try to run 10 races. You know, financially, you're looking at a commitment of, you know, over $500,000. Hopefully, we accomplish that. that goal with a few of the marketing partners we're working with right now.
Who are those partners? Go ahead and share us with them.
Brian and Jimmy Mahoney of Prestige Siteworks, Jeff Hermanson, Farm Boy Custom Company, and Upper Cut Turf Management, and Chip Lofton, Mr. Strutmaster. So
lastly, Paul, for...
And one more, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
John Marucci at Florida Breaking Truck Parts does a lot for us.
Awesome, awesome. So, with this event, hanging out in the pits, again, thank you for the behind-the-scenes access. Been great this weekend. I saw your reaction to the Nitro bill. How crazy is Nitro, actually, as a fuel?
As a fuel? Well, it makes it, I mean, it makes its own oxygen. So it's pretty volatile stuff. That's really where we get the big horsepower from. You could have basically that motor has half the compression of what your standard car motor has. And we have a big supercharger that, of course, we put the nitromethane in there and it creates that oxygen and detonation and it just throws enough to make the motor. So, and obviously I saw that bill. The prices recently have increased on us, but we're working, the government's working that out for where we purchase it, and hopefully those prices will come down fairly soon. I've been assured they're going to come down and actually be a little bit cheaper for us, which will help the racers a lot, because when we get bills like that, especially an independent team, we can't afford to come and pay that kind of money.
Definitely, for any owner, less shocks is better over a race weekend.
Absolutely.
Paul, look, thank you for your time. We hope to see your team running those 10 races next year.
I appreciate it. You'll definitely see us in Gainesville.
Awesome, man. Thank you.
All right, thank you.